People ask me about motorcycles. A lot of times they're a little bit, you know, they say it's dangerous. But I always ask them, have you ever spent any time on a motorcycle? I challenge them to stay maybe for a week on a seat of a motorcycle and see what it's like. And tell me on day four that it isn't magic. And once you do that, well, my challenge to you is to try to stop. I started with three motorcycles, used, and a tarp. And now we've grown to 43 bikes, and we do 15 countries. When I started MotoQuest, I started with the idea of showing people Alaska. Alaska is just one point of the compass. Now we look at our whole menu of things to do. Where does MotoQuest go? Well, as far as you can go on the continents. We go to the oldest and fastest and most dangerous motorcycle race in the world at the TT. We go as high as you possibly can in the Himalayas, Kardung Lah. We go to the Far East. You can enjoy a very distinct culture in Japan, something that foreigners rarely see. We go to Laos and Vietnam. We don't go to the big headline places. We try to stay on the back roads. Meet the locals, eat their food, see their lifestyle. I mean, the people that sign up for these tours are doers, and they're risk takers, but they love life. Our groups tend to stay in touch with each other, and they end up invariably becoming friends for life. Number one is the camaraderie. When I came up with the idea of MotoQuest, that's exactly what it is. It's a quest, and the motorcycle takes us there. We want to get normal people in extraordinary situations.
It's really very green at all. In fact, it's more gangrene. Dressing up an alley cat and calling her queen. And all the junk is trading needles in the middle of the day. And all the muckies wearing mucky suits and they're waiting in bay.
Frankly speaking, this is my best tour. Ah, what can I say?
Cause what you say is what you get.
Alaska Off-Road Camp, we developed this one for folks who love to ride off-road, who love to track, and want to explore places that are so remote in Alaska that you only go as a group to this backcountry. We take you to the foot of the tallest mountains on the continent, and we go see all sorts of wildlife, caribou, moose, bear, and you really get to the heart of natural Alaska. This tour is for those who want to save a little bit. I mean, the price point is hard to beat. You could camp. You can also do hotels, so that's no problem. We spend half the time on the Denali Highway, which is a fantastic scenic destination. And then the other half, we go to Wrangell-St. Elias National Park. And that place is beautiful. It has 9 of the 16 tallest peaks in North America. And we go to the center of that park. So it's really a great way to not only see Alaska, but also ride some challenging roads. Now we start in Anchorage, and we go up to Cantwell on the Denali Highway, and then we head east, and we stay out at one of my favorite places It's called Gracious House, and it has all the amenities we'll need. We stay out there a couple days, and we do outrides from there. And then we continue on to Copper Center, and we have a place right on the river where we set up our tents. And out of there, you can ride into Wrangell St. Elias. There's several really great outrides. You can go to Valdez, which is arguably one of the best paved rides in the world. So lots of options. I think that the riding is significantly, it can be challenging, as challenging as you want to make it. I think if you want to learn how to ride on the pegs and do water crossings and use your bike to its fullest potential, then this is a must. There's no way you can go away not being a much better rider after spending a week on the off-road camp. And our guides that are on that trip have instructed in the past and are professional riders in their past. So if you wanted to focus on your technique or become a better rider, that's by far the best tour that we offer for that.
It's really barely green at all. In fact, it's more gangrene. Dressing up an alley cat and calling her queen. And all the junkies trading needles in the middle of the day. And all the muckies wearing mucky suits. And they're waking at bay. Cause what you say.
Every candy is bad for you.
Is this hot or what?
We're in Alaska with MotoQuest Tours. I'm psyched to be going. It's my first time in Alaska.
We are going to play hard and then have a party.
I'm excited!
We're in the only country that is still friendly with North America, with the United States.
What time did it fly? David, look where we're
not doing my hair tonight.
Get some hair for you.
We couldn't top yesterday's day of riding. Everyone looks even happier than yesterday.
Bear trolling. And Zamla's bike seat's already got peanut butter stuck under it. He doesn't know it yet.
But... You know, I felt bad about peeing in your tent earlier.
To have you come and stay.
happening between us. We just need some time away.
Chicken. Downtown chicken. It's just like Bike Week, only different. This is Bike Week and chicken. But the people are every bit as foolish, and I'm happy to include myself in that category. Silly tourists buying chicken things, chicken-related things. Where's Bill? I want my picture taken with Bill in a chicken suit. Do we have a chicken suit? That was Norman. Are you still filming?
First time in Alaska, and this is the way I wanted to see it.
Not behind a window in a tour bus or backseat of a car, just out in the wilderness, just the air against the face, and really the only way to travel.
consciousness. Is that the greatest mystery? Well, take a ride into your mind and you'll find out all that you could be. Take a ride on that path in the universal tapestry. Reconnecting humankind, the children of the earth are we.
Just went to Prudhoe Bay. How do you feel?
It was fantastic. It exceeded my wildest expectations, and my expectations were quite high.
They're coming back with a high tide.